the load impedance R. Okay, now we'll see how to do impedance matching with the help of this quarter wave transformer using Smith chart. Okay, so name it as some points here. This is A, this is B, and this is C. So our object is, after the quarter transformer, impedance should be matched, because we are using this transmission line for impedance matching purpose. Therefore, at C point, the impedance must be equal to Z0. Therefore, this is Z0 and this is Z0. Therefore, impedance matching takes place. Therefore, there is no reflected wave from here onwards to the source side. The reflection may occur only at this terminal, but after this quarter transformer, there is no reflected wave to the source side. Okay. Now, I am drawing a Smith chart to explain the concept. Okay. This is impedance, this is the Smith chart, normalized Smith chart. What is the first step you have to follow? Always the first step is plot the normalized load impedance. So, in this transmission line, what is the load impedance? This is R, because I am taking this for case 1, where the impedance is only real. So this is point A, and this is point B, and this is point C. The length of this line is how much? Always this is lambda by 4 only. Okay, what is the first step you have to do? Plot the normalized load impedance. What is this one? Z0 is the characteristic impedance of the line. Therefore, and what about this one? It is having the characteristic impedance ZOX. Okay, since load is connected to this transmission line, we should normalize this load with this characteristic impedance, not with this characteristic impedance. That should be remembered. So here the load is connected to this quarter wave transformer whose characteristic impedance is ZOX. So definitely we should normalize this load impedance or resistance with ZOX, not with Z0. Okay, so what is the value here? The impedance at this point is how much? This is R by ZOX. So where this point lies, already we discussed this point. This contains only pure real values, and outermost circle is pure imaginary. So since this point is purely real, definitely it lies on this real axis. I'm assuming that this is at this point. R is equal to A is equal to RL R by Z O X. And it is RL R something, anything as load impedance or load resistance RL. Okay, that is the first step. So what is the next step we have to take? So from this point, I can take like this, because it is connected directly here. So no need to do write one more point here. So this is my load, so this is A. Okay. Since I am straight away connecting the load to this quarter transformer, I want to take another point here. This is A and this is B. Okay. So from this point, we should move a distance of lambda by 4 to reach B point. So in the previous topic, what we have discussed, moving on line is same as that of moving on constant VSWR circle. So what I have to do now? We have to draw a constant VSWR circle. So this is with OA as radius, draw a constant VSWR circle. Okay, So from this point, how much distance we have traveled? Should travel distance of lambda by 4. Okay, already we seen, right? This is the one complete cycle. That means 1 lambda. So this is going to give lambda by 4. So this is a, we have taken it as a short circuit point, and this is an open circuit point. That means if you draw a distance of lambda by 4, it is going to give the inverse point. That's the point, right? So here, from point A, draw a distance of lambda by 4. So this is lambda by 4 distance, right? So at this point, what is the impedance you can take? It is the inverse of impedance at A. Therefore, this gives 1 by RL by ZOX. That is equal to ZOX by RL. So this is the impedance at B point. Okay, because travel distance of lambda by 4 is going to give inverse point. There's one more point regarding the Smith chart. Travel distance of lambda by 4 on Smith chart gives inverse point. Therefore, it is going to give inverse point. Therefore, the impedance, the normalized impedance at B is equal to ZOX by RL. Okay. So what you are trying to say here? So after this quarter transformer, definitely the impedance must be matched. That means what? That means this is the normalizer, right? So first of all, find out the absolute impedance at B. Absolute impedance is equal to how much? Normalized impedance into Z0. That is equal to, what's the value of ZP? ZL bar B, ZOX by RL into ZOX. Here the character impedance is ZOX. So we take the ZOX, it is equal to ZOX square by RL. So this is the absolute impedance at point B. So what I am trying to say here, after the quarter transformer, impedance match to occur. Therefore, this should be equal to Z0. Then only you can say that impedance matching occurred. That means I can take ZOX as root of Z0 into RL. That means we should design this quarter transformer with the characteristic impedance equal to geometrical mean of Z0 and RL. Okay. Then only the impedance at B point is equal to Z0. Okay. The impedance at B point should be equal to Z0 only when we are designing a quarter transformer with the characteristic impedance ZOX equal to geometrical mean of Z0 and RL. Okay. Okay. So what is the drawback in this method? Whenever the load impedance, here the ZOX term depends upon RL. So whenever load impedance varies, ZOX varies. Therefore, as the load impedance varies, we have to keep on changing this quarter transformer with the desired ZOX. Then only impedance matching takes place. That's a drawback in this method. To overcome this drawback, we are moving for a single stem matching technique. Okay, before that, it is load is real. In case, if it is complex, in that case, how to do impedance matching? That is for case 2. So here, so this is the quarter transformer. So what we have to do here is, we have to place one more transmission line of different characteristic impedance. Before this, this quarter transformer. So here you can see two transmission lines, different transmission, three lines. One is your main transmission line. Another one is the quarter transformer of length lambda by 4 with the characteristic impedance Z O X, and third line of some length. We don't know that length. Based upon load impedance, we have to set the location of the quarter transformer with a different characteristic impedance. So the idea here is, since it is complex RL plus some JXL, okay, the idea here is we know how to match a real load with Z naught. Therefore, we have to use one more transmission line of some length L, such that after this point the impedance is some real value. So the idea here is converting this complex load to real value with the help of a third transmission line. That is only the difference. Okay, if you come and put this smith chart here, the first point is, so let us assume this is the complex load. This is R plus JXL. What is next step? With the OA as radius, should draw a constant base depth circle. Okay. So have to choose this length in such a way that after this length it should give some real value. Okay. So move on this constant VSWR circle. So this is nothing but your this line. Okay, so that it is going to give some real value. So after moving a distance of some L suffix C on this constant VSWR circle, it is going to give real value. Now here we know, so from this R, move a distance of L suffix C lambda by 4 to reach this point P. So this is nothing but your A point, this is a B point, and this is C point. Okay, now from this this is a B point, travel distance of lambda by 4, nothing but this is the one, it is going to give C value, it is having some impedance. This impedance should be equal to the, this is the normalized value, this value must be equal to the absolute value of C. That value must be equal to Z naught. That is the procedure you have to follow while matching a complex load with Z naught. Okay, so this is all we know. How to match a real load with Z naught. The one more point here is, first converting a complex load to a real load with the help of a third transmission line. Okay, so this length again, the location of this quarter transformer varies, depends upon the load impedance. If it is here, this is the length. If this is here, this is the length. If it is here, this is the length. Okay, therefore as the load impedance varies, you have to keep on change the location of the quarter transformer for impedance matching purpose. Similarly, we also change the characteristic quarter transformer with the different ZOXs based upon the load what we have at a B point. So these are some of the drawbacks in a quarter wave transformer technique. So you can overcome these drawbacks with the help of a single stub matching technique. Now we'll see single stub matching technique for impedance matching purpose. Second one is single stub matching. Okay, next class we'll discuss about the single stem matching technique.